yeah. Bucktown, Bucktown, New York Giant, dance when I touch down. Subway killer, colorful name, study right out the king from St. James. Birthplace of the cough up a lung, big homie dot turn everybody young. New school, of course I do my thing though, with my rock box and a black tango. New Air Forces or the Chuck Cheese, Chuck Jewelry, lay on the white tee. Fools got me tangled, let me find out. Put a perm on that, straighten it right out. Only city, you can sell Knicks. Get your bell rap from JT Smith. Then learn something from a South Bronx teacher. It's all sell pies, not raise pizza. I walk the walk, name ring bells from the south to north. What else? That's how I do on the fresh to death, arm and hammer piece lay across the chest. What else? Till I'm laid to rest. I'm the
always love, let's go, baby. Always love, welcome to Respect My Journey. Except I'm your host, Carl Krauser, aka Cruising King, aka King Krauser, aka that old black magic. What's going on, y'all? God bless, always love to the people. You know I got to keep an affinity on this thing, man. Today's episode, we have to talk about it. It's real life. He's one of my pit brothers. You get what I'm saying? He's one of my New York City brothers. He's one of my melanated brothers. My young prince working to become a young king. Still 19 years old. Young fella. You know, I just don't want to mess up his name. I just want to keep an affinity here. You know, Femi Aldulke. Okay? Femi Aldulke. He's from Brooklyn. He's from Brooklyn. He's a Brooklyn, New York guy. Point guard. You know, he played at South Shore. And he played there for one of my, I can consider him a friend. You know, close associate, friend, teammate, brother. Played with me, with Doc, you know, with the student athlete Broncos. Salute to Doc. R.I.P. every day, all day. 100% miss you and salute you. Salute to Miss Sandy Naselli. Salute to Joey. Or everybody, his daughter, sister, everybody in the family, okay? Salute to that Bronco community, okay? All of my Bronco brothers. Super salute to y'all. Because I want to keep this calm, nice, light, and polite. And I want to talk to you people right. Please allow me to adjust my chair right. Because, you know, we have to sometimes, like, take the time out to salute our brothers and sisters for their accomplishments. But as I was saying, man, like, this kid, Femi, man. All right, now let me just get back, because this kid, pause. I'm not even going to say that he excites me, pause. Like, he is like, it was almost like a breath of fresh air watching him play and watching his young fella, his teammate Richmond play, who's at Syracuse. You know, Kadari Richmond. He's at Syracuse right now. Salute to Kadari. This kid is like a mix between me, a little something with the in and out, hezzy spin move, bang, and spin move, set him up, PG vision, head is always up, having fun, showing passion, but leads in a calm way, like Penny Hardaway. Now, after he played at South Shore, killing with Kadari, it was crazy. How you gonna, they had a number of people, a number of players playing there that was sick. And I'm going to do another video. But right now, I just want to respect Femi's journey, man. Femi's a 6'5". 6'5", 6'4", 6'5", point guard. tall point guard like Penny Hardaway. I know Penny's like 6'8". I get it. You know, 6'7", 6'8". But Penny, he controls the game in a smooth way. He gets through the crowd. He dissects offenses. He gets through transition, and he sees things that are so cerebral, you only feel they're instinctive. He makes a lot of instinctive plays, and people couldn't teach that. And I remember having so many problems coming up as a kid because people always thought they can, like, overcoach me. And then sometimes, some of these people, like, in New York, like, when we in New York, we have people with microphones. We have, like, a commentator. We have a big, huge crowd and following. We have this type of pressure in these games that you see in Dykeman, Rucker, Gersh, all over the city, Watson. You get what I'm saying? Like West 4th, all over New York City. We have these battles. Salute, IS-8, all over, I'm saying. You know, and it's crazy that we have these crazy stigmas because of where we go to school, because of who we're coached by, because of who we around and who we know. Who knows what this kid has been through in Brooklyn? Growing up in Brooklyn is tough by itself. Growing up in New York City is bananas. I'm just telling you, from all eras. That's why I respect all eras in New York. We're never going to get this twisted. Every era of New York was rough. And it still is rough. I salute all of my New York family, all my New York associates, friends, people that all my New Yorkers did. Like, super salute because it's tough. Let's get back to Femi. Femi is a 6'5 guard who emulates Anthony Hardaway and myself with different moves, but this kid has his own path, his own journey. He's wearing currently now number 2 at the University of Pittsburgh. He's coached by Coach Cable, who played at the University of Duke, who coached under the great Coach K, who I've played against the USA team in the Olympics in Vegas. And I was playing for the USA Virgin Islands basketball team nationally. I say that to say this. I'm recognized amongst the greats, Hall of Famer, Hall of Fame basketball coaches, Hall of Fame basketball players. I am. That Bronx symbol, that's internationally known by myself, and I consistently threw that up. This kid, Femi, consistently stayed out of trouble. He consistently respected his family. He consistently went through different trials and tribulations in New York City, which all can bring us all down. And he still believed in his coach, Sean Mark, who played with me, with the New York City Broncos. Like, come on, man. I went from St. Thomas More Prep to Notre Dame Prep. This kid went from South Shore to Commonwealth, Springfield Commonwealth Prep in Massachusetts. Nick Cornelius was his coach. Well, Cole, excuse me. That was his coach. But what I'm saying is this kid averaged 17.5 points, 8.2 rebounds, 8.5 assists. I mean, 8.8 assists, excuse me. 1.2 blocks. Shooting 52% from the field. Are you serious? Like, super knock it off. And at the same time, like, at the end of this, man, I want you people to free this man. I want you to free this man, and I want you to free this man. Because Femi, He was there. Like, literally, including 39% from the three. Knowing this kid has range. He comes off the hezzy. He comes off the behind the back rap. He drops Dom's no look. He has no look, Dom's. He's from New York. He has that street gritty grind game from the streets. He has that I know when to win. I know when to take over. I know when to drop this dime. I know when to get this steal and this rebound. He's athletic. He does it all. He has the intangibles. Let him play. What is wrong with you? How do you have all these weapons? This is what I'm saying about a lot of coaches that don't know how to get a lot out of their players. You get what I'm saying? They don't. They don't know how to get it. They don't know how to relay the message to these kids to get the most out of them, that gorilla, that passion, that heart in them, that energy that you just know is real. It's mine. I'm here. Why don't all these other North Carolina players get a chance to play and then extra nice guards like Femi get a chance to have to sit behind and chill and do all this extra? Come on, champ. You have weapons on the bench. You have weapons in your arsenal. You might as well use them. It's like having one of them super workout dudes you see with the moves, and you don't want to use none of the moves in the game. That's in the form of coaching. You have all of these weapons, and you don't want to bust none of them. You don't want to let them go. You have to give them the confidence to go ahead and make a mistake without looking crazy, without squatting down, without doing the Stevie Wonder closing your eyes. You have to install that positive energy in them so they can go out there and be aggressive on defense. They might get an instinctive play on defense. They might help their teammate. They might even use some extra communication that might help us. One on the left, one on the right. Hey, I got your back, big man. I got your back, guard. Switch, screen. Screen left, back screen right. That communication, we need that. It's substantial. It's necessary. Who are you? Are you a coach? Did you play the game? Or did you play for the game? Or did you play the game? That kid Femi deserves to be out there rocking. He's a New Yorker. We wanted the New York heartbeat. We wanted that energy. He feels that energy beneath his feet. He is from there. He is a Brooklynite too. I'm a New Yorker. I'm a Bronx king. I'm the cruising king as well. But at the same time, I'm King Krauser here. You have to respect this kid's journey. You have to understand that this kid is ready. Long arm, long reach, defensive player. He recovers crazy on offense and defense. He's unselfish, great kid off the court. I've talked to a lot of people in New York. I have a lot of ties. My nickname is that old black magic for a reason. I created my whole name. I created my whole body by blessing of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why it's one God, one me with this number 11. Lord Jesus Christ, I'm complete 10 toes, 2 feet. Watch me. If you don't knock it off, Pitt plays tonight against Northwestern. Let's see if number 2, Femi, let's see if he's going to get in there. Let's see if he's going to get in the game. Let's see if Coach Capel is going to come outside his body and appreciate that he has a future legend on his hand. He has an NBA pro on his hand, a number of them. Ithiel Horton, number 4, pro. Let that 4 go. Ithiel Horton, let that 4 go. When I played at Notre Dame Prep, I used to be feeling... I used to feel so suffocated. I felt like coaches just trying to hold me back for a second until I showed them. I had to show them on the court. You have to trust me. Let me rock. Let me play. I'm going to kick the ball up, which I wasn't accustomed to doing in transition. I'm going to talk on defense. I'm going to lock my man up because I understand it starts on the top because I've played against grown men early, just like this young kid Femi has in New York City. We all have that in common. We play against grown men in the hood, and it's different than y'all hoods out of state. I know y'all dislike it. I know y'all hate when we talk about this, but New York Street City basketball is the real. Front of you want to. We got players there. Some of you coaches just don't want to do the work. How you think I got to prep school? Another coach, an Italian man, came and helped me and paid for my school. Do you get what I'm saying? He took the time out when I messed up and made a mistake. You get what I'm saying? An idiotic mistake. Somebody looked out for me. God has blessed this kid with a soul. He's a piece of God's light. You gotta let it shine bright. You gotta let it shine bright. Excuse me. Because the song I used to listen to was We Gonna Make It. Like literally, man, we're gonna make it. And that wasn't just for me. That song by Jadakiss and the Lox, We Gonna Make It, We Gonna Make It. That wasn't just for me. My brother put me on to the Lox when they were underground singing the China Door song. That kid Femi has different, like a different, whole different type of memory of his upbringing, his generation. He's went through a lot. He deserves to be on that court right now. Just like Sharif Cooper deserves to be on that court right now. These people deserve to have their light shining bright. You can't keep keeping people from their God, from their light, from their destiny. They are bound to be good. They are bound to be blessed. They are bound to succeed. This is what we are doing. We are chasing the pursuit of happiness, but we just don't want it. We are earning it. We're working for it. We came from a lot, and we're working for more. And it's about building your legacy. These kids, these people are trying to build a legacy for their families, their future kids, their future, like, relationships. And for their past ones, and for the people that love them and care about them and sacrifice for them, how dare anybody take that away and try to tear that down? Salute to Trey McGowan's out there in Nebraska. Man, salute to Shamik too. It's real. Let me just get a few seconds of magic time. Please, thank you. Bear with me 1 second because I want y'all to hear this, man, because this is real and this is what kept me strong with Brian Gartenhire, Ryan Gomes, Joel Wiggins, and a lot of different other people, man. Big Brian, Mike Cleaves, Elvis Bibbs. A lot of different players, a lot of different people, man. You know, Big Brandon. Silly, man. It's just crazy. But Femi, we have to free Femi. We have to free Sharif Cooper and get ready for Omar Cooper. Femi all the way. Deuce up. Let's go. Let number 2 do his thing. Give me a second, please. Give me 1 second. Let's go, Femi.
We gon' make it, we gon' make it, we gon' make it. We gon' make it, we gon' make it, we gon' make it.
That's what it's about right here. They said it was about this. They said it was about the people. You kids, let them know. I want you people to know. I want you people to get it. Know what I mean? Gotta have those last drum blows right there. Pause. I want you people to get it. You get this, right? This right here, this jersey, this jersey. See that? No name on the back, number zero, right? And that's a practice jersey, right? I want y'all to understand something. When y'all come to these universities and these places, when y'all get there, they want y'all to feel like y'all more than zero, right? And then y'all more than zero. But when you get there, they want you only to represent that name on that front of that jersey. And to represent that name of that coach. Because that's who gets the success. That's who controls the narrative of these commentators talking about you, how good they talk about you, your family, and everything else. And how well their ties are to your family. See, we're not stupid. And you know I'm going to tell y'all the truth. I'm going to keep it infinity. So, with that said, you kids, you young fellas, you young ladies, represent that name on the back. Represent that name you carry in your heart, your last name. Represent your first name. Understand you are a reflection of your family every day you stand up and you walk outside that house. Outside that room, outside into the world, into the public. Somebody is always watching, literally, literally. You get it? Somebody's always watching you. Make sure you have on the proper things. Make sure you smell good. Make sure you take care of everything. Be a charismatic person. It is okay to be so. Yes. Read. Learn different things. Ask questions. Speak up. If you're hurt, do not play. Don't let these people mess up your life and have you out there hurting later on. And feeling these different pains because they really don't care. They only care about their check after. They only care because if you're not going to help them win and sustain their job, guess what they have to do? Put you to the back, kick you out, make you transfer. And then now, guess what? You're stuck out there in the cold because guess who can't speak up for themselves? Guess who doesn't have a platform because these people that are friends of these people are going to say, oh, he or she is combative. They're a problem child. They're this, they're that. And it's all to cover up something, but you can't speak up and protect yourself. It's not throwing people under the bus. It's people that threw you under the bus for their own selfish and purpose gain. For finances, for public gain. That kid Femi deserves to play. Sharif Cooper deserves to play. These are our young kings. They're working to be young kings. They're there now. Let's go. It's your host, man, Carl Krause, the Cruising King. Right over left, we the best at All Black Magic. Let's go, Free Femi. X up, peace, man. Enjoy the game tonight. Salute to y'all. Thank y'all.
Hit the like button, baby.